It is like I've always been doing art ever since I was a child. I do work in various mediums and various kinds of things happens in the work. So it obviously it's not actually coming from one particular space. And till you're completely convinced with the idea, you know, and the concept behind it, then you don't get into it. Trial and error is not my process. Looking at the city was a much later occurrence. It was mainly because of the way I approached the city and the city was taking me in, especially Delhi. Different parts of the city has different kind of cultural orientation and therefore different kind of class hierarchy operates, and you would know all these details in one walk from one place to another. That was kind of a fascinating experience for me. Mythology is very much a part of every one of us, and you do so many things in your life which has probably has no purpose or reason. But yet again, your mind is somehow connect that to make it into something reasonable enough for you to understand and digest it. So this, you know, that over a period of time in that, when that happens, that actually become a myth. That is how the myths are being made. The idea of Trojan horse, as you know, it is very clear that, you know, it has an element of betrayal. So the Trojan horse on the peripheries of a city space, in a way, intend to say that, you know, the space is taken over, and again it will take over. Elevator from the subcontinent was one culmination point of a lot of work which I've been doing in the face of the urban area, because it shows about the hierarchies, class and everything all in one particular assemblage, and it is a journey. Yet again, the journey has so much of limitations, because that you could never escape the feeling of either going up or going down. I was sitting and looking at all the archival images of Mao and Gandhi for a very long time. Then I realized that, of course, there is nothing common in their life stories or in their philosophical understanding or in their attitude towards life or anything. You don't see any parallel. But at the same time, you see a lot of parallel in terms of how a nation building take place through the archival imageries. You know, once you ideate and articulate and start moving ahead with your production, so you probably move around in different directions to find a space where you could work. So practically, a studio space is a very fluid space. It cannot be a static space in one sense.